Konnichiwa, Gwan, one and all. This is a short tutorial on finding the volumes of frustums. So, here we have a picture of a frustum, and it looks quite a complicated shape to work out the area of, but we've actually created this by taking a cone and then cutting the cone off at some point and to create the frustum. And here, we obviously have two shapes now. I've taken a cut in the middle. The frustum is the shape at the bottom of this cone. Kind of looks like a circus podium stand. And on top of that, we have the cone in purple. So to find the volume of this green frustum, what we're effectively going to do is find the volume of the big cone, find out what the volume of that shape is, and then we're going to find the volume of this little cone, and we're simply going to do some subtraction. So actually, we're just going to find the volume of cones, but in doing so, we're going to find the volume of a frustum. So here's an example of a cone that's been cut to create a frustum at the bottom of this cone. Now, if I want to work out the volume of that, I'm going to need to find the volume of the whole cone and take away the volume of just this top little cone that's been cut off. So first of all, let's find the volume of the whole cone. Now, in many qualifications, including the GCSE, you are given the volume of a cone as 1/3 pi r squared h. So in this case, if we're looking at the whole cone, we've got 1/3 of pi times the radius squared, and the radius of the big cone there is 4 centimetres, so 4 squared times the height, and we're looking at the big cone at this stage, so times 10. Okay, now I'm just going to leave this in exact form, but if I find the area of that, 4 squared, 16, times 10, it's 160 over 3 pi. So that's the volume of the whole cone. Now, if I want the volume of just the frustum, I'm going to have to take away the little cone on top here that I've just outlined in green. Now, I have the height of that cone as 5 centimetres. I obviously need the radius of the circle at the bottom. Now, this little cone, you can see, because it's 5 centimetres tall, is half the big cone of the original. So the original cone had a radius of 4 centimetres. Well, this is just going to have a radius of 2, because it's half the size. And so, using the formula again, we're going to have 1/3 pi, and this time r squared, that's going to be 2 squared, and the height is just 5. So this time that equals 20 over 3, and that's because 2 squared is 4 times 5 is 20, 20 over 3 pi. So that's the volume of the small cone. So now, bright red so you can see it, if I want the volume of this frustum at the bottom, and I know I've drawn all over this, but this shape at the bottom here, then clearly what I need to do is take the big cone that was 160 upon 3 pi. My pen's just gone a little funny there. And I need to take away the little cone on the top that was 20 over 3 pi. And therefore, the volume of my frustum equals 140 over 3 pi. And you could do that on a calculator to get a more sort of a numerical answer without the pi. And because pi is roughly 3, those 3s are roughly going to cancel. You're going to have roughly 140 cubic centimetres. So that's how you find the volume of a frustum. There's no formula for it, or if anyone gives you a formula, all they're really doing is say, find the volume of the big cone and take away the volume of the little cone. That's how you find the volume of a frustum. If you found this video useful, please share it with someone, put it on your Facebook wall and tweet about it, because other people are going to thank you for every mark you get them in their exam. And if you need more help, do visit mathormaths.com and do get in touch via any of the media displayed on the screen. I really want to help you, I really want you to do well, and I think you're going to do just fine. So good luck.